Hello everyone, this is Garrett and this is Painkiller. And we are going to do level 3 of chapter 3, the military base. And here we are. Now I have been reading the comments of people that have pointed out a couple things to me that I wasn't actually aware of, which are actually some pretty cool things. One of which is that with the stake gun, if you use the grenade and immediately fire, then the grenade you shoot will effectively function as a rocket, and it's pretty great. It works very well, and granted we already have a rocket launcher, but regardless, it looks pretty cool to shoot a grenade with a stake gun. And there is actually some other stuff as well that we will see as we progress through the level, one of which is that these guys actually explode when you shoot their flamethrower, which is actually a pretty good way of killing them. By just stunning them first by shooting them once and then just shooting their flamethrower. The only real downside is they do explode, so it does deal a little bit of damage to you. And it can be a little bit scary, but it's nothing really to worry about. Because we're going to get so much health in this level that I'm sure nothing is going to go wrong. I mean, we're already at 31. That's a pretty good amount of health. But there's also a health power-up coming up ahead. And I'm actually just going to do this again because it's a lot of fun. And we don't really get to use our stake gun very often in this level otherwise. Because the shotgun is actually just really, really good for this particular level right here. But every now and then it is fun to switch it up a bit. So another thing that I read was that the electric gun, this one, actually does have a third fire like a lot of other weapons have. Like the painkiller has this and this, and you can also just shoot it like that. The thing is, though, it costs a lot of electricity to use, but it is actually really quite good. So the next time we're going to face, well, a whole bunch of these guys, only not in this particular area, we'll probably be using that, because not in this particular area, because I don't think I actually have enough ammo to use it right now. Also, another thing to be aware of is that the flamethrower guys, if they hit these little guys with the flamethrower, the little guys catch fire. And when they catch fire, they sort of go into this berserk mode, which is a little bit spooky. And I don't really like being spooked. And also, I'm trying to keep these three barrels over there alive, because there is a secret area on top of that building. And those three barrels make it pretty accessible, really. I believe there's also a box somewhere. Maybe it's inside that building, or not really sure where it is, but you can take it from somewhere. And then you can just painkiller jump on top of the rooftop, so if you have destroyed these barrels, then it's not the end of the world, but I just prefer doing it like this. But yeah, everything's dead. I'm actually going to grab this stuff over here because ammo is always good, and the shotgun is going to be very prominently used in this level. And I think that's it. So I am just going to make sure I have everything, and I am going to quick save, because if one of these barrels falls down, I will just video edit my way to reaching the top of the roof. But let's see what happens, because this is a bit fiddly. And the barrels do have a tendency of just falling off, which is rather unfortunate, really, but we'll see what happens. So we put it here, and we mash the jump button, hope, and we believed hard enough for a jump to actually go correctly during this stupid playthrough. It's probably the first jump in the entire playthrough so far, and that is kind of a miracle on its own. So from here, there's an invisible wall above this fence, so we're actually going to have to shoot this barrel, which is stopping that car from driving into that building over there. Sometimes the door doesn't actually open when doing that, but then you can just jump on top of this truck. Like, there's some pretty easy ways to just get on top of it, and they can just jump over it like that. So it's not the end of the world if the door doesn't open, but if the door is open, you might as well go through it. Also, there's an armor inside this building, which is quite nice, because these guys do hurt a little bit more than I would like to admit. I think I'm actually going to wait for these souls to disappear, though, because having demon mode immediately might not be useful. I might actually... Ah, but... Oh, well. Let's just immediately run in this direction. I think there should be an enemy here. And then when we kill it, it should open this door. And now we only have a very small amount of time to kill everything in this particular area. It's a bit of a waste of demon mode, if you ask me, but oh, well. I couldn't be bothered to wait anymore, and I was impatient, and that's what happens when you get impatient in this game. But it's fine, there's not that many enemies here, so it's not really the end of the world. Besides, we still have our shotgun with our wonderful secondary fire, which takes care of almost everything in this game. And of course, we have our stake gun, which kills everything at a distance. And every now and then, We might shoot a rocket or two as well and just miss entirely with it. But it's the thought that counts. I tried to kill them with a rocket launcher and it would have been totally cool if it worked. I am just incompetent. So inside this building, this might actually be a better place to get demon mode just because there's actually quite a lot of stuff in here. And a bunch of stuff explodes here as well, which is a little bit worrying. And it's very easy to get hit by explosions, and then that thing blows up as well, and everything has the potential to hurt you here. And with demon mode, you just sort of jump around, go upstairs, kill everything here, and yeah, it would take care of things a little bit quicker. Fortunately, with our newfound knowledge about killing these guys by shooting their flamethrower, these guys are no problem at all. There is one thing I kind of forgot to mention, which is the tarot card unlock status. In this level, you have to just kill all of the enemies. And there are a couple enemies which are missable, but it's nothing we're going to have to worry about because they're just in a couple of extra buildings you can enter, which might not be immediately obvious. I think the biggest part when you do this level for the first time, which might confuse you a bit, is just the level layout, because there's a couple places where it's like, where am I supposed to go? Like, the elevator over there might not be immediately obvious. Shooting the flaming barrel. The first time I played this level, I got stuck there because I didn't even see that flaming barrel for the longest period of time. So I just sort of walked around there for, well, forever, really, until I accidentally saw, oh yeah, flaming barrel. I guess that's kind of important. But oh well, nothing we have to worry about now. Another thing, which I suppose we can talk about while we're here anyway, is that people pointed out to me that my geography is bad. And that Zurich is not, in fact, in Germany, even though the signs were all in German, it is, in fact, in Austria. And I could basically go on an entire tangent about how bad my geography skills are, which would start somewhere along the sentence of, hey, did you know Georgia's a country? I found that out last year, and not just in a state in America. And that truly shocked my core of existence. And my excuse would be somewhere along the line of, in Dutch, it's pronounced as Georgia, and it's a little bit different, but in the end, it's all excuses, and I'm just bad at geography. I just don't really care about geography all that much, so every now and then, when there's a geographic question which the game proposes to me, I will probably get it wrong. But geography aside, we killed all of the things, and there are secrets waiting for us. And also this small amount of money right here. And, I'm just going to jump all the way down. You can actually just go down two of these things and then you can go through that door. But I would prefer to just go down all the way because otherwise we basically have to climb a ladder twice and I don't like doing that because it takes for ages. It takes for ages. That's totally properly English. This ladder in particular, like if you go up from the normal entrance, which is just that grating over there, you have to climb that all the way down and all the way up and it's just a lot faster to just jump down, so I just prefer doing it using that particular method. Just gonna jump around over here and make sure that everything is dead before continuing onto the next area. This was also a place where the first time I played this level, I was like, what am I supposed to do? But that was because I couldn't see this ladder. That ladder is actually quite hard to see because it blends in with the environment perfectly. Because everything has to be a specific color in realistic games like these. And this is a pretty realistic game if you ask me, so what are you gonna do? I'm not gonna do anything. I'm just gonna move on. I think everything's dead, but I'm just again gonna make sure because that tarot card unlock status is killing everything, and I do believe you might actually be, like, you might get away with just killing everything on the top floor here, so might as well circle around one extra time to make sure everything is dead. If you jump down here, you're gonna end up, like, way at the start of this building again. We're actually one floor higher than we were previously, and this seems to be the only way to get on top of this floor for as far as I know. Aside from maybe painkiller jumping off of some of those weird things, but we want to get up here because we want to climb up, and there's a new enemy type! It's a big turret thing! And I'm shooting it with a rocket launcher right now. You can actually just use a shotgun as well because of the way damage works in this game. Like, the game doesn't really care what weapon you use against which enemy, so if you see a turret like that, you can also just hit it with a shotgun. This guy's taking a while to, yeah. Don't know why it took so long for that guy to turn into a green soul, but it just did. Not gonna question it. Now, next to these turrets, there are actually another new type of enemy as well, which is a little bit more worrying, actually. Like, these guys do hurt quite a bit when you get hit by them, but as long as you just keep moving, they really shouldn't hit you. As long as you just keep circling around them. It shouldn't pose any threat at all. But there's also tanks now, and tanks are also not very fun. They're basically turrets that move, and as you can see, the shotgun takes perfect care of them. Now, since we have quite a lot of ammo right now, we're going to use the lightning and then immediately use a shuriken, which shoots one of these things. And I should have shot a little bit closer. But as you can see, it actually takes care of these guys quite well. It works quite well against weaker enemies, but if you look at the bottom right, I had like 300 lightning bolt ammo, I suppose, a second ago. And now it's like at like 60 or something. It uses up a lot of ammo, but it is actually quite good against these guys. And honestly, to me, it's probably the best use of the weapon itself, just because I'm just not a really big fan of the weapon, really. So I would call anything, any excuse to use that weapon is a good excuse, as long as it's actually useful. Now, here's an enemy that gets stuck here for some reason, like that guy in particular. He gets stuck there a lot. And I'm going to turn into a demon here because there is another tank. And tanks just take a few extra shots to kill compared to the average little guy. And killing everything here spawns that tank as well, which we can then immediately destroy with our demon mode weapon as well. And tanks really aren't exceptionally dangerous or anything, but they are a little bit more dangerous than everything else here. So taking care of them that way, a little bit safer in my opinion, and also a little bit quicker since tanks do actually take quite a beating before they die. And you can end up wasting quite a bit of ammo on them, but nothing we really have to worry about. I think there's ammo under some of these. Yeah, there's ammo under that particular vehicle. So if you want to get some extra machine gun bullets, they're just hiding all over the place. But there are actually some other ammo locations here as well, some of which are in secret areas. And the first one of those is on top of this airplane right here. And it can be a bit finicky to get on top of this. At least you can use the wheels to get on top of it pretty easily. And then you just keep jumping on the sides and you should make it to the top of it, where there is some more ammo waiting for us. And inside the plane, there is actually some waiting for us as well. You can use painkiller jumps again, as per usual, pretty much. But you can also actually just jump off of the enemies, which spawn over here. Which should get, like, if we can get a little bit of jumping going on, which for some reason is not really working out for me right now. But usually you can just jump on the enemies and just keep mashing the jump button. And considering we have 2 health right now, not going to fiddle with it anymore. But usually, usually that does work. Just take my word for it, you guys. Where you can basically just mash the jump button while just hugging those guys, and there really shouldn't be any problems at all. But unfortunately, things didn't go quite as planned. Fortunately, there's always a plan B. And plan B this time is this box, which should make it pretty easy to get to that ladder right there. Still a little bit fiddly, unfortunately, but what are you going to do? I am just not very good at jumping. I mean, we got one jump right, and of course we have to pay the price for that by just immediately, colossally messing up the jump that comes immediately afterwards. Is that good enough? There we go. We got on there. There is also 100 health power-up, which is why I wasn't too worried about having 2 health. But more importantly, there's a whole bunch of ammo and an armor as well. So we are pretty much perfectly set up once again. There was just absolutely nothing to fear there, just because there was just so much health and armor waiting for us over there anyway. Now, there are 3 buildings over here. We're actually going to have to visit all 3, and we can only visit them from the back door. And the reason we're going to have to visit those is because each of them is filled with a small amount of enemies. Not really anything to worry about, but as I've mentioned several times before, we do need to kill everything to get that tarot card. And for that, we're just going to have to enter these extra buildings. And there is some extra ammo here as well, in case you want to get some extra explosions going on. We actually have quite a lot of ammo for this gun, so I might end up using it a bit more. But there's a bunch of flamethrower guys here. And explosions don't really work very well against these guys, in my honest opinion. I think the shotgun is just a better choice for these guys, just because the secondary fire takes care of them a lot more safe, I feel, just because they don't explode the way they do when you shoot their flamethrower. And they're pretty close by anyway, so anyway, we've been fighting about 3 enemy types here, so you could probably guess which was gonna be in the building, considering we had the 2 other ones in the other 2 buildings. And killing those guys gives us a little bit more shurikens, which is great if we use those at all, but we really don't, so I'm sure there's someone out there who's very happy with that ammo, but I'm pretty indifferent towards it. Now, moving on, there is a building over here, and I believe I'm actually on pace to getting everything I want, so I'm just going to move forward. This is also another place where having demon mode is actually not bad, because there is a fair amount of enemies here, And if you have the new emote, you can basically just go upstairs and kill everything upstairs. And then just go downstairs and kill everything that's still remaining downstairs. And then you won't really have to worry about anything that goes on here. Fortunately, the enemies are not very strong, in my humble opinion. And you just gotta make sure you don't get set on fire or something like that. The shotgun does a really good job just because everything is really close quarters. Every now and then we can switch to the painkillers for these guys just because these guys are that weak. And I kind of don't want to go into demon mode now. That would actually be kind of a waste, honestly. And that might mean... Well, never mind. that's rather unfortunate. But there's nothing we can do. We're going to have to go up an elevator right now. So I'm just going to grab some remaining ammo that's downstairs. I would have thought I could grab that, but I guess I already have full ammo for that gun as well. And I don't think there's really anything else going on here. I'm a bit confused why the battle music is still playing, but I do know the location of at least one more enemy, so maybe it was just because we were in demon mode that the battle music was playing all this time. But at the same time, there is one more enemy waiting for us up here, which is that guy. And he spawns a checkpoint. Still kind of sad about that demon mode, but what are you going to do? At least we got three souls again, so we're well on the way of getting demon mode once again. And onwards to that checkpoint. Now, I've had the game crash, and also there's an invisible wall above this fence, so sometimes you can get stuck behind it. I've had the game crash going through this checkpoint. I kind of hope that doesn't happen this time, and it didn't, so that's cool. And a turret just sort of plonked itself there, which looked a little bit silly, but oh well. We have plenty of explosives. There's a bunch more ammo over there if you need it. I'm not going to get it because, honestly, I'm lazy. And I don't care about picking up every ammo power-up there is in the level anyway, so I'm just going to shoot at things. There is actually a secret area all the way over there, but there is, in my opinion, a better route of getting it, which is just by playing the level normally. And we'll be getting that as the final secret in this level instead. But know that there's a secret there, and if you are missing one at the end of the level, that might be the one, because it is pretty easy to miss if you don't go all the way there. This is just a really large area, which makes sense considering, of course, it's like an airplane base and a missile base. It's a military base. It has a bunch of stuff in it, and of course you need a lot of room to do that kind of thing. And they also, of course, want to have their tanks move in a nice and maneuverable area, so they have plenty of reasons as to why this place is built the way it is. But just keep it in mind that I am not going to get it right now because I am lazy and I don't want to walk all the way there. And I'm just going to shoot with this gun for a while. Why not? We don't really use all of our guns that much because of the shotgun being so good. Might as well just shoot that in the middle right there. The electricity weapon right there doesn't really work against those flamethrower guys very well, which is a little unfortunate because of the fact that it basically just stuns them. And this actually works quite well as well. They just seem to instantly explode when you shoot their flamethrower, so that's nice. I'm not sure if the electricity, like, the disc you shoot on the floor, if it actually damages the flamethrower guys or if it only stuns them. But either way, if you want to stop them from moving and also simultaneously damage everything else, it works quite well. So, something to keep in mind. Now let's shoot that guy because he was the last remaining enemy, I think. No, there's still a couple more, but is this going to hit? That might miss. Yeah, I figured as much. I always have a little bit of trouble estimating where exactly I'm supposed to shoot with this gun when it comes to distances like that, but it worked out in the end, so it's fine. And another turret left as well. Let's use our grenade thing. Well, man, sometimes this kind of thing just doesn't work, but fortunately, the stakes does still hit the enemy, and turrets don't care if you shoot them with a stake or an explosive. It does damage, and that's all that really matters. Now, there's a couple secret areas in this place waiting. There are 7 secret areas in this level. We've gotten 4 so far, one of which is on top of this plane. This can also be a little bit fiddly. This one doesn't really have wheels you can jump on top of, but if you just go close to that particular edge, it shouldn't be too difficult. Then you can jump on the back of the plane over here and nearly fall off. Let's try that again. Usually, if you just keep mashing the jump button in the middle here, you should just go all the way up like that. And on the roof over here, we have to go all the way to the back, and you can already see the holy item waiting for us over there. and another secret area was found. So that secret area was pretty well hidden. The next one, I'm still not 100% sure why it counts as a secret area, but I guess like the checkpoint thing isn't pointing towards it, but there is a doorway over here. And most of the reason we're going here is because it's a secret area, but even more of a reason is because we need that tarot card. Well, we don't need the tarot card, but I want the tarot card, and for that, we're gonna have to kill all these guys over here. Hiding in the secret area. They might think secret areas is a good place to hide, and usually it is, but this time, it's just a little extra stuff. No, our health and armor is still looking pretty good, so I'm not really gonna worry about all the damage I'm taking right here. Otherwise, you might want to take it a little bit slower by just hiding behind the walls over here and just take them out as you go in this direction. But honestly, there's not much to worry about here. Not really sure if there's still any alive. I'm just gonna grab that just to make sure I have enough secondary fire for the shotgun, because it's so good. I love this gun. It works so well against basically every enemy in the game. So might as well make sure we have enough ammo for it. And it does appear everything's dead. You hear voices every now and then, but that's just ambient noise from the game. So I'm just gonna climb up here, grab this armor, max our armor out again, which is very nice. And this is actually, for as far as I know, the only way to get out of here. Because there's actually an invisible wall above that wall, which seems a bit unnecessary considering you already have a wall. But what are you going to do? They need a wall on top of their wall, just in case the wall isn't good enough, I guess. Now, moving towards this direction, we should see a bunch of barrels. Huh. Usually there's a whole bunch of barrels or whatever, just explosive stuff, just sort of in this corridor. I guess it blew up at some point in the past. Probably one of my failed grenade shots towards that turret earlier that just ended up hitting it. But usually there's a bunch of stuff there which would have a bunch of money inside it, which would have been nice to get, but oh well. It's too late now, the stuff is already gone, and we don't have anything to worry about again. Again, this is not a bad place to get demon mode as well. Honestly, our demon mode locations have not been great for this level so far. And I'm actually just going to use my tarot card, why not? There's not really many good places to use tarot cards in this level, I feel, so I might as well use it over here. Get to see that slow motion action, which always looks very odd, but oddly satisfying at the same time, dealing a whole bunch of extra damage because of that Fury card. And Fury works quite well against ordinary enemies. It works quite well against bosses, and as you can probably imagine, ordinary enemies don't quite have the same amount of health as a boss. And therefore, it will just destroy enemies everywhere. It is very nice. Keep that up. Grab that money over there. Or just make it go through me for some unknown reason. Grab all this stuff. Unfortunately, enemies do spawn a little bit slower when you use that tarot card, obviously. But I just like using them. They just look fun. There really wasn't a really good reason. It's not like I was worried about dying, because our health and armor is pretty fantastic right now. But it's just fun. I just like seeing things in slow motion. It's my playthrough and I'll do what I want. So, moving on. I do believe everything there is dead. There's a whole bunch of these little corridors right here. You can actually see these from the other side, because this is actually where we came from, just over there. And there's just these little fences blocking off the place, so you can't just jump to the end, unfortunately. But, yeah. Let's try to stay away from that barrel or crate or container. That's the word I was looking for. Eventually, I'll find the right word if I just keep saying different ones. Because it explodes and does a little bit of damage, which is a little bit unfortunate, but what are you going to do? Nothing to worry about, really. And I'm just going to jump around here for a while until they're all nice and close to each other. I don't really like using tarot cards here because it's a bit of a mess. Like, there's only really weak enemies mostly here, and there's not really much of a point. I probably should stay away from those because I don't really want to activate demon mode here. And there's quite a lot of souls over there, so I should just stay away. Make sure that I just kill these guys from a distance. That explosion took care of a lot of stuff right there. And I don't think there's anything over here anyway. Yeah, it doesn't look like it, so there might be something on top of this plane if you just go up the stairs right there, but I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to grab all this money, which is happily lying around over here. If you do really want to see what's upstairs, I guess I might as well just go upstairs, see what's going on. But I'm pretty sure there's really not much exciting stuff. It's just a lot of corridors, really. If you want to jump on top of a plane in an easy manner, this is pretty much the easiest way to do it. But we've jumped on top of several planes at this point, so I'm pretty satisfied with our plane jumping quota for this particular video. And instead, I'm just going to move forward over here, where there's a bunch of tanks. This, again, I don't like using the tarot cards over here either, because I believe stuff spawns while you fight these guys, and you kill the tanks really quickly, and then you just sort of wait for the other enemies to spawn, and you just sort of sit there in slow motion for a long period of time while nothing is happening, and that's kind of awkward. These guys are actually immune to the freeze gun, I believe, like the secondary fire of the shotgun, which is rather unfortunate. But then again, it is a tank, so, you know, they get away with it on the basis that they are, in fact, a tank, and those are actually usually quite durable. You wouldn't expect it, but that is actually the case, even though you can destroy them with a shotgun. Don't worry about it. It makes sense where you don't think about it too much. I'm just going to make sure that I avoid those souls, because I don't really want to have demon mode in an area without enemies again. And behind this door, there's some extra health. There's another armor. Again at 200 armor, we're pretty much nearing demon mode over here. And there's a UFO, and there's a whole bunch of sort of freezingness going on over here. It's very blue, at least. And I'm going to kill these guys and probably take their souls at the same time, because there's actually quite a lot of enemies over here. One of them jumped all the way over there. Can I get that? Ah, I can. Wow. That's sort of surprising, actually. But might as well just kill everything here. I don't know how fast these guys spawn. It does look like they spawn pretty much instantaneously after killing the first batch of guys. But unfortunately, now we're going to go through a similar experience as to what would happen if you use tarot cards over here, which is that you just sort of sit here waiting for enemies to spawn. At least most of the bigger ones did spawn over there, so we got rid of a couple of the flamethrower guys, which is nice. Except for that guy who's taking a lot of beating, unfortunately. And might as well use our rocket launch for these remaining guys over here. I believe these might actually be the last enemies of the level over here. Just gonna make sure that our enemies kill. Yeah, 347 out of 347. And as I said previously, we're now all the way over here, and there's a remaining secret area hiding over there. And I just prefer this route because I don't want to jump all the way here and then end up here, because usually this door will just be closed and then you just have to jump all the way back again, and it's not too exciting to look at, to be perfectly honest. But having grabbed that, we can go on the top of the UFO into the sparklies and beat the level. Apparently 25 minutes or so. I'm gonna click that away because it's not too exciting. And there you go. Also, the plus 60 that's next to gold found, which someone mentioned in one of the really early videos, and I don't think I ever really talked about it. Apparently, if you like juggle enemies in the air with the painkiller, apparently that goes up. I'm guessing it works for other weapons as well, but I'm not 100% sure how it works. But apparently, if you use the painkiller to just make enemies fly a bunch, that gold found goes up. But that's all I really know about it. It's not something I really bother with, just because our money is fine right now. And it's just not something we have to worry about. But we killed all the enemies and we unlocked Greed. Doubled amount of hidden wealth, which is, I don't know. It's alright, I suppose. It's pretty expensive to place. If you want to just farm a bunch of money by just killing, like by just repeatedly doing the same level over and over, that card, I guess, is pretty good, considering I do believe it's it's a silver one, so it would just work for the entire level. And for that, it's pretty good, I suppose. I'm probably not going to use it. If I am going to use it, it's probably going to be off-screen, because it's not very interesting, is it? It's just a number that goes up twice as fast, and not much to show off there. But that was level 3 of chapter 3, and the next time we play, we are going to do level 4 of chapter 3, The Ruins, and I hope to see you there. Bye-bye.